Hello everyone, how are you all? Welcome to my channel Natural Biology. This is Shankar sir. In the previous class, I have started the chapter 16 of NCERT Digestion and Absorption, and also I gave the introduction about the topic, what is mean by digestion, how digestive system is further classified, what is mean by alimentary gland, accessory organs and digestive glands. Okay, so once you review or once you check the video, first lecture one, okay, then you will get the clarity here. Okay, so this is about the human digestive system. Okay, so digestion in human being is done by digestive system. Okay, so this is about the digestive system, and I also gave you what is mean by alimentary canal and what are the parts of the alimentary canal. Okay, alimentary canal is a long tube. Alimentary canal is a long tube. It extends from mouth. So this is the opening called mouth, and this last opening is called anus. So alimentary canal extends from mouth to anus, and it is modified into different organs. This canal is modified into different organs to do different functions. Okay, right. I will give first briefing of the parts, where the parts are present and what is the name of the part, and later we discuss about the points. Okay, one by one, point wise. Okay, so myself Bhagyavar Shankar, MSc Zoology. Okay, and NEET faculty, NEET Zoology faculty. And why? Because this class is only in the English medium. Deep student from different states like Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, and also from East India, even North India. North Indians will speak only in Hindi. Okay, most of the videos I have seen in the YouTube and in Hindi medium. Okay, English and very less English, more in Hindi. So that is why that makes some difficult to listen the especially South India students and East India students. Okay, so because of that reason, these classes only in the English medium. So have to understand. And your local zoology and local biology also helpful. NCERT topic, but it may be in your local syllabus. Okay, like government, like state government syllabus. Okay. And right, we'll discuss about the alimentary canal. Alimentary canal. So the first part of the alimentary canal, so this is called the mouth. What is this? Mouth. Then what is mean by mouth? First I will give the briefing parts names of the alimentary canal, digestive tract. Mouth. Mouth lead into this space. So this area is called buccal cavity. What we can call this? Buccal cavity, are also called as oral cavity. Okay, now the buccal cavity opens into the next part. This is called pharynx. Pharynx. Then pharynx opens into the next part. So this is called esophagus. Esophagus or food pipe. Esophagus or food pipe. Now the food pipe opens into the next part. So this area is called stomach. Now stomachs continue as a small tube like structure. So this complete tube like structure, which is lined with the blue color, is called small intestine. Small intestine. And this small intestine opens into this part. This is called large intestine. Large intestine. So this is the small intestine, then it is opens into large intestine, and the last part of the large intestine is the rectum, and the exterior opening is called anus. Okay, so these are the parts of the digestive tract, alimentary canal. Alimentary canal also known as GI tract, gastrointestinal tract, gastrointestinal tract, or simply GI tract, gastrointestinal tract or GI tract. Okay, extend from mouth to anus. okay, and some of the organs also helps to this digestive tract. As we know that here salivary glands are present, okay, here one pair of salivary gland, here one pair of salivary gland, and here also, okay, I will write one salivary gland, okay, together called as salivary glands, and there is the largest gland which is called a liver, and there is a small sac-like structure in the liver at the base of the liver that is called gallbladder, and there is a gland helps in digestion. This is called pancreas. Pancreas. Just wait. Pancreas. Okay. So this is the glands. So glands of the digestive tract are salivary glands, liver, and pancreas. Even gastric glands are present at the lining of the stomach. Intestinal glands present at the lining of the intestine. Okay, this is the complete picture and view of the digestive system. Okay, mouth leading to a first chamber. This area is called vestibule. Here I written. We will discuss later. Then it opens into this area that is called oral cavity or buccal cavity. Buccal cavity. Then we can see the throat. When we see the mirror, okay, then we can see the throat, that is called pharynx. Now the pharynx opens into a chamber, not chamber, it is a pipe, food pipe, it is called esophagus. Then esophagus continue as a stomach, this is the stomach, then stomach into small intestine. Okay, in small intestine also there are three parts. First part is called duodenum. Later we'll discuss, okay, duodenum. And the next part is called jejunum, and the third highly coiled area is called ileum. So duodenum, jejunum, ileum, parts of the small intestine. Come to large intestine also shows three different areas. The first chamber of the large intestine is called cecum. Okay, don't worry, I will give in detailed manner. We will discuss about the structure of the small intestine and large intestine also in the next class. Okay, right. Cecum. This large area is called colon, and the last area is called rectum. In colon also, this is the ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, and sigmoid colon. Then rectum, and final exterior opening is called anus. Okay, so these are the parts. Let us discuss one by one. Okay, first mouth. Okay, then what is mean by mouth? Mouth is a transverse slit-like aperture. Okay, like it is a balloon. There is a transverse slit. Okay, so this is called mouth. So mouth is, it is not total mouth. Just the slit is called, the opening area is called mouth. Okay, it is bordered by upper lip and lower lip. Okay. Upper lip is called labrum and the lower lip is called labium. This is the labrum and this is the labium. And exteriorly, these lips are covered with the skin. Inner side, here, inner side, they are covered with the mucous membrane. Okay. Here I will write external area is covered with the skin. And internally, it is covered with the mucous membrane. Okay, so that is about the mouth. That's all. Mouth is a opening of GI tract, gastrointestinal tract or digestive tract, bordered by upper lip and lower lip. That's all. Now the mouth lead into the next part, that is called vestibule. Okay. Then what is mean by vestibule? So when we open the mouth, this is a space, you know, the space between these lips and teeth. This is the area, this total area. That total area is called vestibule. Okay, you can feel with our tongue to the vestibule. Okay, this is a narrow space. It is a narrow space. Okay, it is a narrow space. Bordered by anteriorly lips, posteriorly teeth and gums. okay, it is bordered anteriorly with the clips, posteriorly with the teeth like gums, okay. And you can see here I open, you can see there is a skin of fold, okay, there is a fold of skin, nothing, the upper labrum, okay, is connected with the gums through a fold of skin. You can see the skin here, okay, that is the middle portion of the upper lip is connected with the gums through a fold of skin, that is called superior labial frenulum. Okay, in the same way lower lip, here also you can see the middle fold of skin that is connected with the gums, that is called inferior labial frenulum. Don't worry, it is not mentioned in the NCERT, but we should have little idea about that. Okay, vestibule. Now the vestibule opens into chamber. Next part of the alimentary canal is called oral cavity or buccal cavity. Okay, and it is a large space. Oral cavity or buccal cavity is a large space. Above it is bounded with palate. What is the roof of the oral cavity is formed by palate, and the below this total throat. What it is present? Throat. Sides, cheeks are present and teeth are present. So teeth, sides make the lateral wall, the upper area covered with the palate, and the lower it is a throat. So this total large area, large space is called oral cavity or buccal cavity. Now in this buccal cavity we can see some accessory organs. What are the accessory organs are present in the oral cavity? Palate, teeth, tongue. Palate, teeth, tongue are present in the oral cavity. You can see this is the palate. This hard area, upper area is called palate. Okay, and here teeth are present. As you know that teeth are present on the bone, maxilla. Teeth are present. Even there is a tongue. Okay, tongue also present. This is the tongue. So buccal cavity contain palate, teeth and tongue. So these are the three important parts. Okay, let us learn one by one. What is mean by first palate? As you know that palate is a wall or septum that separates the oral cavity with nasal cavity. As you see here, nose also have a cavity. Opening is present here. Oh, that is called a nasal cavity, and this is the buccal cavity. These both cavities, nasal cavity and buccal cavity, are separated by palate. Okay, and there are two regions of the palate: anterior palate and posterior palate. Okay, so I am taking this area. This is the anterior palate. Which one? This area is called anterior palate and this area is called posterior. Anterior palate and posterior palate. Anterior palate is little hard, okay, not little, even somewhat, okay, very hard, we can feel here. Okay, this is made up of, the hard palate is made up of what, Nana? This is made up of maxilla plus palatine bone. So palatine bone, maxilla, makes the anterior hard palate and which is covered with the mucous membrane. If we see the inner surface here, we can see speed breaker like structures. These speed breaker like structures are nothing but palatine rugae. What are these? Palatine rugae. These palatine rugae helps in holding the food during the chewing. While we are chewing, that will hold the food particles. Okay, so that is a function of anterior hard palate. Come to the posterior region. Okay, here you can see the palatine rugae. Likewise. Okay, right. Now the posterior palate, very soft palate. It is a soft palate. Okay, and it helps in the slimming, means what, pushing of the food, it gives a slimy nature. What? Which type of nature? Slimy nature or slippery nature. Food is going to slip to the next part through this posterior palate. Okay? And there is soft area which is hangs down here. Okay? So this portion of the soft palate is called uvula. 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 So here you can see the uvula. Okay? Uvula. So the uvula is the extension of posterior soft palate into the oral cavity. As you know, uvula close the internal nares. Here these are the external nares. In the same way, here the region internal nares also present. During the swallowing, it closes the internal nares, nothing but nasopharynx. So allowing the food into the next part. Means it prevents the entry of any food particles into the nasal cavity. So it closes the internal nares, thereby it facilitates the swallowing. So this is about the posterior palate. Okay. So palate is nothing but it is the roof of the buccal cavity. There are two areas, anterior hard palate, okay, and posterior soft palate. Anterior hard palate forms many elevations and depressions that is called palatine rugae, which helps in holding the food particles. Whereas posterior palate, okay, this area is very soft, which provide a slippery nature. And also the extension part into the oral cavity is called uvula. It closes the nasopharynx during the swallowing. So this is about the structure of the palate. Hope it is clear. Okay, we have completed what is mean by mouth, the transverse slit-like aperture. Then the next part, this area is called vestibule, and the next part, the space is called oral cavity, buccal cavity. In oral cavity, we have completed palate. Now we will going to discuss about the teeth. Teeth in human being are ecto and mesodermal in origin. If we talk about the origin, so from which embryonic germ layers, okay, it will be formed. So teeth in human being are formed of ectoderm and mesoderm, both. Okay, we have to remember that this question can be framed. Teeth in human being are originated from ectomesodermal origin, or endomesodermal in origin, or endoectodermal in origin, and all the above. So answer will be ectomesodermal in origin. Okay, right. And teeth in human being present in the buccal cavity. Okay, right. Based on their arrangement, based on their shape, and based on their formation, these can be categorized into three types. Okay, so teeth, nothing but arrangement of teeth in the buccal cavity is called dentition. Okay, dentition. Remember that, dentition. And there is a branch of biology which deals with the structure, shape, problems related to these teeth. It is known as odontology. Okay, so doctor or a specialist called odontology. Odontologist branch is called odontology. Specialist is called odontologist. Okay, right. So human being teeth are thecodont dentition. What is mean by these three words we have to remember? Thecodont dentition, diphyodont dentition, and heterodont dentition. Okay, so in teeth in human beings are thecodont dentition. What is mean by thecodont dentition? Our teeth are embedded in a socket, alveoli of the socket bone. Okay, this is the jaw bone. You can see this is the bone. This is the jaw bone. I am drawing this bone. This is the jaw bone. This jaw bone having sockets. Okay, these are the sockets, like depressions, sockets. So now the teeth is fixed in the jaw bone. Here it is our teeth. Okay, then it is fixed in the teeth. What? It is the alveoli of the socket. This is alveoli of jawbone, alveoli of the jawbone, or socket of the jawbone.
So teeth are like, this is the teeth human being, it is a socket, it will fixed like this, okay, tightly fixed. So such type of arrangement is called thecodont dentition, okay. Are you clear? Right. Now if we talk about next point, diffeodont dentition. Teeth in human beings occurs twice in a total life period. Okay, first time we will get that are called milk teeth or deciduous teeth, then later it will be replaced by permanent teeth. So we get teeth twice in a life period. The first teeth are called milk teeth or deciduous teeth, and the second which will replace that are called permanent teeth. Permanent teeth. Are you getting here? Teeth in human beings occurs twice in a life period. Okay, first teeth will form at the age of 6 to 8 months. We get the teeth at the age of 6 to 8 months. So that teeth are called milk teeth. Okay, it will be continue up to 6 years. Okay, 6 to 8 years also. Okay, afterwards 6 to 8 years, these teeth, milk teeth, will fall down. Then it will be replaced by permanent teeth. Likewise, we get teeth twice in a life period. So this type of arrangement is called diffeodont dentition. Okay, in amphibians, fishes, teeth will get many types. Okay, that is called polyphyodont dentition. So in human being, teeth are diffeodont dentition. Sir, what is the number of milk teeth? As you know, they appear at the jawbone. So first lower incisors, okay, the two teeth, their upper two teeth, their canines, okay. Which teeth are absent in milk teeth? This question can be framed as a neat question, okay. As you know, that first we have to know how the teeth are arranged, okay. Right. Later we discuss here. Diffeodont dentition, please, it is clear. Teeth occurs twice in a life period. First teeth, which is formed at the age of 6 to 8 months, are called deciduous years. Afterwards, from 6 years, okay, to nearly 17 or 18 years. So permanent teeth we get from the age of 6 years, okay, 6 years to till the 17 or 18 and so on, okay, right. Now next part, heterodont dentition. All teeth are not same in size and shape. They may vary in their shape and size. This type of arrangement is called heterodont dentition. If all teeth are same, homodont dentition. Teeth are not same, different size and shape, then it is called heterodont dentition. I am taking, okay, the total buccal cavity here. Okay, this is the total buccal cavity. In each half I am taking, in each half in the buccal cavity, this is the upper area. Upper teeth arrangement and these are lower teeth arrangement, right. So here there are two teeth, okay, which are called incisors. I will draw the incisors. These two teeth are incisors, okay. And the next one is called canine. This is little short canine. Then the next one are called premolars. So these are called premolars, and the next three are called molars. Even you can see the roots of the tooth also. Likewise, teeth are arranged. Getting here, what I am drawing, teeth in each half I am drawing. These two are called incisors, and this one is called canine, the single one, projection one, and these two are called premolars, and these three are called molars. So in a order, in heterodont dentition, two incisors in each half, two incisors, one canine,
2 premolars and 3 molars in adult I am talking. Okay.
Whereas in case of this milk teeth or decidious teeth, these premolars are absent. They have incisors, canines and molars. Premolars are absent. Okay. Have to remember that. Hope you understand. 2 incisors, 1 canine and 2. These 2 are premolars and 3 are molars in adult teeth. Okay.
So, if we draw the dental formula, if you write the dental formula, nothing, dental formula is nothing but what is that upper teeth and lower teeth in each half I am taking.
Okay. 2 incisors, 1 canine, 2 molars and 3 premolars. By lower set also having 2 incisors, canines, premolars and molars. So, this is called dental formula. Okay, I will write here dental formula.
This is the dental formula of adult teeth. In each half, upper and lower teeth, 2 incisors, 1 canine.
Here also 2 incisors, 1 canine and 2 premolars, then 1, 2, 3 molars. So 2, 1, 2, 3. 2, these 2, 1, 2, 3.
So 2, 1, 2, 3 by 2, 1, 2, 3 is the dental formula of adult human being. If we write the dental formula for milk teeth, they have
2, 1, 0, 2 by 2, 1, 0, 2. So why it is 0? Which is absent? Premolars are absent in the milk teeth. Okay, point to remember. Premolars are absent in the milk teeth and they have only 2 molars. 2 molars. Okay.
Even in adolescence, okay, after formation of all teeth, after the replacement of milk teeth, also adolescents from age the 13 to the 19 or 17, okay, this total teenage 13 to 19, okay, they have only 28 teeth.
If we consider their number, milk teeth number 20, okay, we multiply with 4, then we get the total number of teeth, milk teeth 20. Now, adolescents have 28 teeth. How many? 28 teeth. Because the last tooth, this last molar appears after the age of 17, okay, 17, 18, 19 also, okay,
or sometimes it may not appear also, okay. If it is appear after the age of 17,
so that last tooth, last molar, okay, in permanent tooth, last molar is called wisdom tooth. What is the name of the tooth? This one is called wisdom tooth, happens or appears after the age of 17. If you draw or if you write the dental formula for adolescents, 2122 by 2122. Okay, so this is the dental formula for adolescents. Okay, dental formula for milk teeth or decidious teeth, 2102 by 2102, whereas 0 is nothing but premolar, that is absent, whereas adolescents dental formula for 28 teeth, 2122 by 2122, just multiply with 4, then we get the number. Then the dental formula for adult is 2123 by 2123.
Even in the earlier examination, there may be question from the dental formula of different animals like rabbit, cat, dog, but now it is not asking what is the thing is given and what type of information is given in the NCERT, that much is enough. Okay, so always remember that. Okay, so the information which is given here, so that is enough for the NCERT. Okay,
right. And hope you understand what is mean by thecodont dentition, diphyodont dentition, heterodont dentition.
Thecodont dentition means teeth are embedded in the socket, okay, or alveoli of the jawbone, maxilla here, tightly it is attached. So that is called, not attached, we can call embedded, embedded into the socket of the jawbone. That type of dentition is called thecodont dentition. Teeth in human being occurs twice in a period, total life period. Okay, first teeth are called milk teeth, are also called as decidious teeth. These are replaced by permanent teeth.
Milk teeth forms between the months of 6 to 8 months. Then these are replaced from the age of 6. Okay, 6 years. Here 6 years to 17 years or more also. But the last tooth appears after the age of 17. So that is called a wisdom tooth. Last molar. Okay. Now, in heterodont dentition. Heterodont dentition means all teeth are not same in size and shape. They vary in their size and shape. So such type of arrangement is called heterodont dentition. Okay. These four types of teeth in heterodont dentition are incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Okay. Why it is called incisors? Because they are like chisel shape. Chisel is an instrument which is used by carpenters, okay, to make hole to the wood. To make hole to the wood. Okay. They need this type of chisel. Okay. And dagger is such type of instrument which is helps to hunt the animals. Okay. This is the dagger shape. The sharp pointed end is there. This is dagger shape. And as you know, the diamond shape, rectangular shape. Incisors are in chisel shape. Canines are dagger shape, premolars are diamond shape, molars are rectangular shape. And what is their number? Total number. Total number of incisors, 8. Total number of canines, 4. Premolars, 8. And molars, 12. All together, 32. How many? Dental formula. 32 teeth for adult human being. Okay? Right. Hope you understand the different types of teeth. Heterodont dentition. Okay? Right. Now we will discuss about the structure of a tooth. Okay? Structure of any tooth. As you know that this tooth shows the three different regions externally. Okay? There are three areas if we see the externally. The part which is visible to us. This is the visible. Now you can see the teeth which is visible to you, white color and neck. That is called crown. What is that? Crown. The visible portion up to here, the visible portion, this area we can see, this visible portion is called crown, and the part of the tooth, this is covered by gums, this area covered by gums is called neck. Okay, so these are the gums, and this area is called neck, and the area which is embedded in the socket, this is the total socket, okay, which is embedded in the socket of the jawbone, so that is called a root. So you can see here, crown, neck and root. Okay, these three parts. Now if we see internally, we can see different areas. The total area of the tooth, bulk of the tooth, most of the areas of the tooth is formed by a hard material which is called a dentine. What is that? Dentine. And this dentine is secreted by special cells which are present in this pulp cavity, are called odontoblast. You can easily remember dentine, D, odontoblast. Okay. This is the total blue color area we can see. This is totally dentine, the hard material. Okay. Which is the very hard material. It is formed by calcified connective tissue. What it is? It is formed by calcified connective tissue and calcified salts are present nearly 70% calcified salts are present, even 70 to 75% also, 75% calcified salts are present. Now this dentine is covered with a white material, so this area is called enamel. What is that? Enamel. So a dentine of the tooth is covered by a white material that is called enamel. This enamel is very very important. It is the hardest substance. It is the hardest substance in the human body. Okay. Which is enamel. Because it also contains calcified salts of nearly 90 to 95%. 90% calcified salts are present. Even 95% also. Up to 95% calcified salts are present. Okay, so hence it is the hardest substance, and which is formed by calcium phosphate, calcium carbonate. It is made up of calcium carbonate and calcium phosphate. Hence it is hardest substance in the human body. It is secreted by amyloblast. The cells which are present lining of the dentine are called ameloblasts. These ameloblasts secrete the enamel. Okay. Now this enamel is ectodermal in origin. It is developed from the ectoderm of the embryo, whereas dentine developed from the mesoderm of the embryo. Hence, human teeth are ecto and mesodermal in origin. Okay, in ecto mesodermal origin, which is ectodermal origin, enamel. Which is endodermal in origin, not endo. Mesodermal in origin, dentine. Okay, not endo. Mesodermal in origin. So hence these are ecto and mesodermal in origin. Right. Now the pulp leaving a space. There is a space inside the dentine. Okay. This area is called pulp cavity. Pulp cavity contain many blood vessels. You can see here blood vessels. Arteries are enters. Okay. Blood vessels are enters through the small area space which is present between the dentine, that is called root. Root canal. You can call as this opening is called root canal. I will write here. This is the root canal through which blood vessels enter into the pulp cavity. Root canal is the area of dentine through which the blood vessels are entered. Not only blood vessels, even arteries inside capillaries. Okay, lymph vessels are enters. Nerves are enters. Blood vessels, lymph vessels, nerves are enter into the pulp cavity. Okay, it contains different types of cells like odontoblasts also present in the pulp cavity. Okay, it is going to nourish. It is going to nourish. Why there is a supply of blood? Because it is continuously bringing the oxygen, glucose for the proper functioning of tooth. Okay, so pulp cavity. Now root canal. Sometimes the root canal may be severely damaged by bacteria. Okay, so that will be treated with a root canal therapy. Okay, root canal therapy. No much information is not given in the NCERT. So just we have to remember the root canal through which blood vessels, nerves and lymph vessels are enter. Okay, next. The enamel is covered with a small membrane like structure that is called gums. Okay, the neck of the tooth, the neck of the tooth is covered with the gums. Okay, gums, or it is also called as gingiva. Gingiva or gums. You can see this is the area, gingiva. A tooth or the neck is covered with gingiva or gums. Then the total area is called root, which is fixed into the socket, that is called root. Okay, and this is the structure of the tooth. Okay, here we have to remember that which type of teeth have how many number of roots. You know, incisors have only one root. Canine also have only one root. Even premolars also have. Premolars having two roots. Premolars are having two roots. Okay. Here it is having only one root. Okay. Incisors one root. Canines one root. Premolar also having one root. But molars are having two roots. Okay. Do you understand here? How many number of roots present to these teeth? Incisors having only one root. Root are attacking this area. One root, whereas canines also having one root, premolars also having one root, but molars are having two roots, lower teeth. The lower surface, lower teeth are having this type of arrangement. Okay, the roots I am talking in the lower surface, tooth are having roots. Incisors have one root, canines have one root, premolars have one root, but last molars, three molars having two roots. Whereas in upper surface, here incisors have only one root, canines have one root, but premolars having two roots. And molars are having, all molars, three roots. How many roots? Three roots are present. Not much important, just for our understanding. Okay, that's all. Right, this is the structure. And lastly, this is the jawbone. In this jargon, these tooth is fixed with a material that is called cementum. Okay, cementum is a material where the dentine is covered with a material that is called cementum. And after the cementum, there is a membrane structure. This is called periodontal membrane. Okay, periodontal membrane outside which is lining the alveolus. After that, inner to the periodontal membrane, cementum is present. Thereafter, root canal. Root is present. Okay. So this order we have to remember. First dentine, thereafter cementum, thereafter periodontal membrane. Okay. This will help the teeth to fix into the socket or jaw. Okay. So this is about the structure of human tooth. Okay. And these are teeth. Hope you understand. In the next class, we will continue about the structure of the tongue. Thank you.